LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about the microwave engineering. So friends, here you are going to learn about the transmission waveguide, that are the rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. You have learned in the previous video regarding what is waveguide, which are the modes can propagate through the waveguide. Here we are going to learn about the waveguide parameters. So friends, which are the waveguide parameters? So first parameter is cutoff wavelength, second is guide wavelength, third one is the groove and the phase velocities, and fourth one is the characteristics wave impedance. The cutoff wavelength is denoted by lambda c. What is the cutoff wavelength? The mode that can exist and sustain in a waveguide are a function of the waveguide dimension and frequency of propagating signal. Each mode has a cutoff wavelength. For a particular mode to sustain, the wavelength corresponds to the signal frequency must be less than the cutoff wavelength or the minimum wavelength which is required to pass through the waveguide. So that is known as the cutoff wavelength. It is denoted by the lambda c. So the cutoff wavelength for a rectangular waveguide for both the TE and the TM mode, okay, which is given by the equation lambda c is equal to 2 upon square root of m by a whole square plus n by b whole square, where a is the wide dimension of the waveguide and b, that is the narrow dimension of the waveguide. The cutoff wavelength of a circular waveguide with an internal diameter of d, which is given by the another equation, it is lambda for the circular waveguide, but this is equal to pi d upon the kr. What is the kr? It's a solution of Bessel's functions equations. There are the various values for the kr for the various mode. So kr for the TE01, TE11, TE21, TE02, TE12 and TE22 modes are 3.83, 1.84, 3.05, 7.02, 6.71. So these are the values we need to consider according to the type of the waveguide that we used. Okay. Again, the KR value for the TM wave, okay, that are also given, and according to the TM mode, okay, you can select the KR value. So what is it? The solution of the Bessel's functions equations. Now here, the various modes and the cutoff wavelength which is given. So for the TE10 mode, we know the equation of the cutoff wavelength, and according to the equation of the cutoff wavelength, we should put the value of the m and n inside the equation to get the final equation for the cutoff wavelength. So TE10, it is 2a, TE11 or TM11, value of the m and n is 11, it is 2ab upon square root of a square plus b square. For the TE20 mode, it is a, TE01, it is 2b, TE11, it is the 1.706d, it is TM01, it is 1.306d, TE11, it is 1.028d, TE01, it is 0.820d, and TM11, it is 0.82d. So this is what for the various mode, the what is the cutoff wavelength. So if we remember the final equation of the cutoff wavelength for the particular mode, then it is easier for doing the calculation. Second parameter is the guide wavelength. The guide wavelength is denoted by the lambda g. Now what is this? The guide wavelength of the traveling wave propagating inside the waveguide. It is always different from the free space wavelength lambda. The guide wavelength lambda g, the cutoff wavelength lambda c, and the free space wavelength lambda, they are interrelated by the equation lambda g is equal to lambda upon square root of 1 minus lambda upon lambda c whole square. So this is the relation between the wavelength, which wavelength? Guide wavelength, cutoff wavelength, and free space wavelength. Now if the lambda value, that is the free space wavelength value, that is less than the cutoff wavelength, then the lambda upon lambda c whole square much more less than 1, and the lambda g is equal to the lambda. So this way we can have the relation between these two. Next parameter is the group velocity and the phase velocity. The velocity of the propagation in a waveguide is the product of the guide wavelength and the frequency. Okay, so Vp is equal to lambda g upon lambda into c. So when the modulated carrier travels through a waveguide, the modulation envelope travels with a velocity much less than that of the carrier and even less than the speed of the light. So the velocity of the modulation envelope is called the group velocity, which is denoted by the Vg. So Vg is equal to lambda upon lambda g into c. Now the Vg is less than the Vp. The modulation that keeps slipping backwards with respect to carrier as the modulated signal travel in a waveguide. C square is equal to Vg into Vp. So for a waveguide which filled with a dielectric having a dielectric constant epsilon, so Vp is equal to square root of epsilon lambda g upon lambda into c. So Vg is equal to lambda upon square root of epsilon lambda g into c. So this is the equation for the Vp and Vg. Here in the diagram, as you can see that how the velocity, okay, of the particular, the phase, okay, and the group velocity, okay, that will travel. Here is the example that is given, okay, that is onto the beach and the ocean, how the signals, they will travel. So what is the wave velocity, okay, what is the group velocity, okay, so that we can understand by taking this example also. Next parameter is the characteristics wave impedance. So the generalized expression for the characteristics impedance Z0 of the waveguide for the TE mode is Z0 is equal to 377 square root of mu upon epsilon B upon A lambda g upon lambda. For the TR mode it is Z0 is equal to 377 square root of mu upon epsilon B upon A lambda upon lambda g, where the mu is the relative permeability of the waveguide material, unity value for the non-magnetic material, epsilon that is the relative permittivity of the dielectric, and which value is a unity for the air filled or the hollow pipes. So for the circular waveguide, the A value is equal to the B value. So for a hollow air filled waveguide, epsilon is 1, mu is equal to 1. For the TE mode, Z0 value is this. For the PM mode, it is 377 B upon A lambda upon lambda g. So for a waveguide filled with the dielectric material, of the material with the dielectric constant epsilon, TE mode equation is 377 B upon A square root of epsilon lambda g upon lambda. For the TM mode it is Z0 equal to 377 B upon A lambda upon square root of epsilon into lambda g. Third, for the hollow and air-filled circular waveguide, the TE mode equation for the z0 is 377 lambda g upon lambda. For the TM mode, z0 is equal to 377 lambda upon lambda g. Fourth one, for the circular waveguide filled with the dielectric material or of a dielectric constant epsilon, TE mode z0 is equal to 377 square root of epsilon into lambda g upon lambda. For the TM mode, z0 is equal to 377 lambda upon epsilon into lambda g. So the characteristics wave impedance for the TEMN mode is related to the free space characteristics impedance, which is that is equal to z0 upon square root of 1 minus lambda upon lambda c whole square. Now we are going to solve the example of the rectangular waveguide. So now here let us calculate the cutoff frequency for the particular, okay, the first four mode of a WR284 waveguide. Okay, so now we need to calculate, okay, for this particular waveguide, the value of the A that is also given, the value of the B that is also we need to take, okay, and here the dimensions for the A and the B, they are given in the centimeter. So now the FC MN is equal to C by 2 square root of M by A whole square plus N by B whole square. Okay, where C is what? It's a 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. We need to calculate for the first 4 mode. So first 4 mode we are going to take. It is the TE10, okay, TE01, TE20, TE11. So these are all modes that we are doing. Okay? We are putting the values of the A and B for this waveguide. We are putting the value of the M and N according to the subscript given to us. So we can calculate the TE10. It is C upon 2A. That is the direct equation you have seen. What is the C? It is the 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second upon 2 into the A. So A value we are putting and we can calculate. Similarly, you can calculate all the values for the rectangular waveguide. Another question is, show that for TE10 mode, a frequency of 8 GHz will pass through a waveguide of dimension A is equal to 1.5 cm, B is equal to 1 mm. If a dielectric with the epsilon r equal to 4 is inserted in the waveguide. So now, the value of the A is 1.5 cm. So what is the cutoff wavelength for TE10? It's a lambda c is equal to 2A. So 2 multiplied by 1.5, that's a 3 cm. Now the wavelength corresponding to 8 GHz, it is 3 into 10 raised to 8 upon the 8 into 10 raised to 9. So it is 3.75 cm. Now since the wavelength to be propagated is higher than the lambda c of the 3 cm, then the signal that cannot be propagated. So when the waveguide is filled with the dielectric, so lambda dielectric is equal to the lambda value in air upon square root of epsilon. What is that value? 3.75. So 3.75 upon square root of 4, it is equal to 1.875. So which is less than the 3 cm, and since the 8 GHz frequency will pass through the guide. The next example is, a rectangular waveguide has a wide and the narrow dimensions are the 4 and 2 cm respectively. So what is the minimum frequency which can be transmitted if a dielectric of epsilon r is equal to 4 be inserted in the waveguide. So A is equal to 4 cm, B is equal to 2 cm, lambda C maximum is equal to 2A. We are putting the directly the value of the A, so it is 8 cm. FC value, it is equal to what minimum value? So the frequency is the 6 GHz, okay, 8 GHz, and the C value is the 3 into the 10 raised to 10 we are taking. So it is the 3.75 GHz. So now the minimum frequency which can be passed without the dielectric is the 3.75 GHz. So but if we insert the dielectric, then the lambda dielectric value is the lambda fraction, okay, upon the epsilon r. So it is which value? So this is the 8 upon square root of 4, it is 4 cm. For FC value, it is 3 into 10 raised to 10 upon 4 equal to 7.5 GHz. So the minimum frequency that can be passed with the dielectric is the 7.5 GHz. Next example is, show that the 1 GHz signal cannot propagate in the PE104 in a rectangular waveguide having a wall separation of the 5 cm. So the cutoff wavelength lambda C for the PEMN mode is given by lambda C is equal to 2 upon square root of m by a whole square plus n by b whole square, where a is the wall separation. So lambda C is equal to 2a upon m, it is 2a. So it is equal to 2 into 5, it is 10 cm. So free space wavelength is what? 3 into 10 raised to 10 upon 10 raised to 9, so it is 30 cm. So as the free space wavelength is greater than the cutoff wavelength for TE10 mode, this mode cannot propagate in the waveguide. So this is regarding the examples of the rectangular waveguide, circular waveguide. Okay, so friends, keep watching LJIET Electronics and Communication for more updates on the microwave engineering. So thank you very much, everyone.